today's episode of 2 Minute Tuesdays, Tips and Tricks Using Mastercam, I'm going to show you how Mastercam gives you choices for mapping colors identically or independently in the main interface and the Mastercam simulator, often referred to as Mastercam Verify. In previous versions of Mastercam, color mapping in the main interface was completely independent of the simulator and was also tied to the simple 256 color palette of Windows. However, the simulator uses the HTML color palette, which supports many more color definitions, and uses a different naming convention that may be unfamiliar to some. Now, one simple checkbox in the simulator options links your main system setting colors to the simulator defaults. Let me show you how this works. To begin, in this earlier Mastercam version file, you can see a part model, stock, fixtures, and sample toolpaths defined for this demonstration. You can also see that with the shading turned on, these items are displayed in the colors assigned to them in their properties as individual entities. If you run the classic backplot function, you can also see that the tool is rendered in several distinct colors. At the top left corner of the screen, go to File, Configuration, Colors, and then highlight the item called Mill Tool Cutting. Note that the color shown in the box above has the number 55 next to it. This is one of the 256 colors defined in the simple Windows mapping system. However, when running the simulator, you can see that the rendered colors shown for the part, stock, fixture, tool components, meaning the cutting length, shoulder length, and shank, and the tool holder have some differences. In the simulator window, go to File, Options, and Graphics. Now, you can see the color definitions are radically different. In simple terms, these color numbers are using hexadecimal in place of decimal values, which, while yielding many more choices and combinations, can be confusing to someone not used to working with them. Next, let us look at the same part file in Mastercam 2023 interface. Look at the top left corner of the screen again as we select File, Configuration, and Colors. Note the new branch options for defining the simulation display. These definitions are still using the 256 color Windows palette. Once the colors are defined here, the new machine group setup makes it easy to choose the desired colors for the part. Finally, after launching the simulator, we will once again go to File, Options, and Graphics. Notice the single simple checkbox at the top. This allows us to override the HTML color palette and use the definitions from the main interface. You can save all these settings by following the on-screen prompts. As you can see, Mastercam gives you a choice between simple display options and more advanced ones if they are desired. All it takes is a few mouse clicks. Well, that's it for this episode of 2 Minute Tuesday's Mastercam channel brought to you by Cimquest TV. We hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.